Another one down. GOP Congressman Lamar Smith won't seek re-election to House. Old GOP blood has been dropping like flies in recent weeks, with many career politicians declaring they will not seek re-election, and the latest is Texas Congressman Lamar Smith. Representative Lamar Smith, chairman of the House Science, Space, and Technology Committee, says he won't be seeking re-election after 16 terms in office. Smith, a Texas Republican, said in a statement Thursday, "This seems like a good time to pass on the privilege of representing the 21st District to someone else." Smith's district, which takes in parts of Austin and San Antonio, as well as rural counties to the west, has been solidly Republican in the past. He completes his term as committee chairman for the GOP at the end of 2018. Unfortunately, Smith is one of the better Republicans. Smith is skeptical climate change is caused by human behavior. He also encouraged Americans to get their news from President Trump and not the news media. He has been mostly a solid conservative. Smith has carved a name for himself as the GOP chairman of the House Science, Space, and Technology Committee, especially in the last Congress when he often questioned the Obama administration's focus on climate change. Smith used his perch on the science panel to undermine the Obama administration's efforts to elevate several global warming skeptics to question the agreement among the vast majority of climate scientists that humans are the main driver of the phenomenon. The congressman is proud of his work on the panel. "For several reasons, this seems like a good time to pass on the privilege of representing the 21st District to someone else," Smith said in a letter to supporters. "At the end of this Congress, I will have completed my 6-year term as chairman of the Science, Space, and Technology Committee. I have one new grandchild and a second arriving soon. And I hope to find other ways to stay involved in politics." Smith added that it has been gratifying to have been named one of the 100 most influential people in D.C., one of the most effective members of Congress, and Legislator of the Year. "Our nation faces many challenges, but we will always prevail if we put the interests of American citizens and taxpayers first," Smith wrote. "A successful democracy requires an honest media, true patriots, and respect for the rule of law. All of us can do our part to help promote these ideals." During the Obama administration, officials at the National Science Foundation, the Environmental Protection Agency, and the Energy Department all found themselves in Smith's crosshairs. The 69-year-old lawmaker, who previously chaired the GOP House Judiciary Committee, also made regular attempts to expand his committee's jurisdiction over cybersecurity to launch far-reaching probes targeting the New York Federal Reserve, healthcare.gov, and the companies that provided software to Hillary Clinton's email server. He antagonized the broader science community when he touted a number of NSF grants as frivolous and sought to restructure how different areas of science were funded by the federal government. Smith also subpoenaed the EPA for health data used for clean air regulations, and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration under the suspicion that a scientific paper on climate change was mishandled. Smith has served as a GOP committee chairman two other times, on the Ethics Committee and on the Judiciary Committee. The congressman also actively intervened on behalf of ExxonMobil amid high-profile investigations by Democratic state attorneys general into what the oil giant knew about climate change and when. He convened a congressional hearing on the matter and demanded documents from the attorneys general that would reveal the inner workings of their investigations. One of the most senior members of the delegation, Smith has had a low-key style of leadership. For example, in 2014, U.S. Representative Ralph Hall, a Rockwall Republican, faced a fierce primary threat from now U.S. Representative John Ratcliffe and had very little money to fend off the challenge. Smith realized before most that Hall was in trouble and rounded up campaign donations from the other Republicans in the Texas delegation. When asked if the toxic political environment contributed to his decision, he was emphatic. "No, it had no impact on my decision whatsoever," he said. The news was not entirely surprising. Smith's name has repeatedly surfaced as a GOP member of Congress with the potential to retire. But there was one argument for why he should stay. Smith is a deft legislator and had positioned himself to possibly succeed another Texan, U.S. Representative Michael McCaul, R. Austin, as chairman of the U.S. House Homeland Security Committee. Speculation immediately began among Texas GOP insiders about who could succeed Smith in his seat. Names included state reps Jason Isaac and Lyle Larson, and Austin City Councilwoman Ellen Truxclair. State Senator Donna Campbell's name was also put in play. A spokesman for Campbell said she will carefully and prayerfully consider what is best for her in the district. Austin-based communications consultant Jennifer Sarver, a Republican, confirmed that she's taking a serious look at running for the seat.